news. We have a little competition for that here at this point.
We do.
Bill Shope and the news, and both are all right.
I wouldn't mind having Huey in here.
Huey, great guy, man. I'll tell you what, he was so much fun when we had him in Portsmouth for Rock and Roll House Party, I believe it was 11.
Wow. That was a huge get.
Yeah, it was. And he still one of the best I've ever seen. And at the Vern Reif Center for the Arts. It is downtown, 64 degrees. Time for the news brought to you by Portsmouth Cancer Care and Associates, Dr. Inoshita, Dr. Jaffrey, where the care, compassion, and roadmap to your recovery begin. Once again, here's Bill.
Thanks, Steve. Good morning, everyone. 42-year-old Rusty Rule, who pled guilty to vehicular homicide in the death of his fellow Portsmouth resident, Rich Moon, has filed a motion for a judicial release. Moon's death nearly 4 years ago eventually resulted in a 54-month prison sentence for Rule, who was also charged with leaving the scene of an accident that resulted in death. Rule filed the motion himself back in mid-June. Now, accounting for time already served, Rule has spent 11 months in prison at Chillicothe Correctional Institute. Meanwhile, health officials here in Ohio are warning about the resurgence of a virus that hasn't been in the news much recently. Tracy Townsend explains.
Spartan Stadium, as usual, and the gates will open at 5. Fireworks will go off at 10. We'll have a huge kids section. It is free to 18 and under. There is a $5 charge admission for over 18, so 19 and up. But, again, the kids get to play on everything for free. There's all kinds of vendors. There's a bunch of food trucks. There's all kinds of stuff going on inside. So we try to encourage everybody to come in. Fireworks go off at 10 o'clock. We have live music, Landon McGraw and Wild Sun, and that'll start at 6:30.
That was not obviously Tracy Townsend, but we'll hear from her at the next broadcast. Meanwhile, the 13th of nearly two dozen superloads and second of four loads that exceed 900,000 pounds will depart the dock site in Adams County on Monday, July the 8th. The convoy will head to New Albany to deliver the load to the site of the new Intel plant in Licking County before making a stop overnight on the west side. This load, an air processor known as a cold box used in the silicon chip manufacturing process, weighs over 916,000 pounds. Now, the move is scheduled to take more than a week. It will make stops in West Portsmouth, Lucasville, Chillicothe, Rickenbacker Air Force Base, Pickerington, and Pataskala before being delivered on Tuesday, July 16th. As a reminder, these extra-large loads will have significant traffic impacts as they move, and motorists are strongly encouraged to plan ahead and avoid the route while the load is moving. Complete route details can be found at transportation.ohio.gov/superload. And Washington Township will be conducting mosquito spraying tonight and tomorrow, both evenings, 6 p.m. until 10 p.m. For Mix 99.3 News, I'm Bill Shope.
And I know how excited about the fireworks you are, so that's the reason I think we preempted the other cut there for Brian Smith. Saw him over the weekend.
Well, we've had a lot of people call in this morning and contact me over the weekend to want information, so now you got it.
Yeah, and we'll continue to dole that out because every time we get to the 4th of July, been in this business a few years, I know how the drill goes.
Oh, yeah, and don't forget New Boston's having theirs the same night as well.
Oh, yeah, and today it is the 1st of July, which kind of even heightens the urge to do what people are going to be doing, and you know what that is, don't you?
You shoot off their own fireworks?
Well, the age is now here, ladies and gentlemen, the season for blowing stuff up. Let's do it!
Well, we're blowing stuff up. Hope we don't die. Shooting fireworks up in the sky. We're blowing stuff up. Hope we don't die. We're celebrating 4th of July. Roman candle on the driveway. Bottle rocket land on the roof. Take a hose and start spraying. My house ain't fireproof. Lighting up a big cherry bomb.
She's next.
I want to see you get up to do the George Jefferson dance now.
There you go. All right. Thank you, man. This update brought to you this morning by Portsmouth Cancer Care and Associates, Dr. Inoshita, Dr. Jaffrey, with her care, compassion, and roadmap to your recovery began. For over 30 years, Dr. Inoshita and his staff at Portsmouth Cancer Care and Associates have been changing lives with the most comprehensive treatment and cure for cancer in the area. During this time in Portsmouth, Dr. Inoshita has created a name of patient excellence in the highest degree and will continue that fight with each and every patient towards the cure. Dr. I, as he's known by his thousands of friends, is proud to announce the addition of Dr. Hassan Jaffrey to the staff of Portsmouth Cancer Care and Associates. Dr. Jaffrey's medical expertise is with all cancers as well as treatment of blood disorders, bone marrow, and the immune system. Together, Dr. Inoshita and Dr. Jaffrey create a very special team that's there when it comes to fighting back to regain your good health. Feel free to stop in and welcome Dr. Jaffrey to the staff at 916 11th Street or call 353-4884. It's Portsmouth Cancer Care and Associates of Portsmouth, always there with the care, the compassion, and the roadmap to your recovery. And 737 it is, downtown sunny 64 and ONN.
This is ONN. I'm Jay Fox on the Ohio News Network. Ohio Highway Patrol reports that in southeast Ohio near Zanesville, a vehicle fire has caused the temporary closure of a portion of Interstate 70. The incident occurred this morning at mile marker 156 on Interstate 70, just east of Zanesville. Travelers who take that route are being asked to avoid the area and seek alternate routes. A deadly house fire over in northwest Ohio's Fulton County claimed the lives of two people and three pets Saturday. Dominique O'Neill with ONN affiliate WTOL-TV has more.
The village of Fayette is in mourning after two people died in a house fire on Fayette Street.
The fire has left a small community of about 1,300 shaken. Michael Sliker lives next door to the home.
Never seen anything like this. It's sad.
And the cause of this fire is still under investigation.
In northeast Ohio, Olmsted Falls native Katie Moon has officially qualified for the Olympics in Paris and is set to defend her gold medal in pole vaulting. Last week, Carson Foster of Cincinnati and Hunter Armstrong of Dover qualified in swimming. At present, there are 33 native Ohioans representing the country in the summer 2024 Olympics, and that list includes NBA great LeBron James of Akron. The opening ceremony for the 33rd Olympics is set for July 26th. ONN affiliate WKYC-TV in Cleveland will have complete coverage. Stay tuned to ONN for updates. For the Ohio News Network, I'm Jay Fox.
And it is sports at 7:39, brought to you this morning by Collier Medical. And, of course, Collier Company is located 1661 State Route 522 in the Berg, and they've got it all for you, including leasing, offering equipment rental at Collier. All right. Well, the Reds kind of kissed their sister and took a shower in a raincoat over the weekend. But
yeah.
Could have, should have, but when you score no runs, you don't.
Boy, in the two wins in St. Louis, the Reds were really, really good. But in the two losses, they were really, really bad. There was no in-between offensively for Cincinnati.
None whatsoever. So with that, we tell you, here's the report. Full and fisted, it's Chuck.
Thanks, Steve. The Cincinnati Reds split a four-game series in St. Louis over the weekend, winning 11-4 on Thursday and 9-4 on Saturday, but falling 1-0 on Friday and 2-0 yesterday. The Reds could only muster a couple of hits in yesterday's loss. Cincinnati presently finds itself 6 games below 500 with a record of 39 wins and 45 losses. The Reds are 11 games out in the NL Central in fourth place. Cincinnati will be off today and will visit the New York Yankees tomorrow. Cleveland dropped 3 out of 4 in Kansas City over the weekend. The Royals won 6-2 yesterday to claim the series. The Guardians will be off today and will host the Chicago White Sox tomorrow. Cleveland currently has a 6-game lead over the Twins in the American League Central. In minor league baseball, the Chillicothe Paints took 2 out of 3 at home against Du Bois County over the weekend. The Paints won the rubber match yesterday 14-6. Chillicothe will hit the road visiting Lafayette this evening at 7. Joey Logano took the checkered flag at yesterday's NASCAR race in Nashville. That race finished with 5 overtime restarts. The finish was crazy as there were multiple crashes and several front runners who had to peel off for gas as they didn't have enough in the tank to make it through all the overtimes. Rounding out the top 5 yesterday were Zane Smith, Tyler Reddick, Ryan Preece, and Chris Buescher. Finally, an athlete with local ties is placed first on the national stage once again. Ironton native Mackenzie Long sprinted her way to the United States Track and Field Olympic team Saturday at the Olympic Trials in Eugene, Oregon. Long punched her ticket to Paris after placing third in the 200-meter finals, clocking in at 21.91 seconds. According to WOWK-TV in Huntington, Tokyo Olympic bronze medalist Gabby Thomas and Brittany Brown, who won silver at the 2019 World Championships, will be joining Long and representing the United States team in the 200-meter at the Olympic Games. While born and raised in Ironton, Long finished up her high school career in the Columbus area at Pickerington Central. Long originally went to college at NC State, then transferred to Ole Miss. Earlier this month, she won the Triple Crown at the NCAA Championships, placing first in the 100-meter, 200-meter, and 4x100-meter relay. She also just signed a deal with Adidas. She says the three stripes represent her three national titles. Her father, Michael Long, told Channel 13 News that a big motivation for McKenzie this year has been running in honor of her late mother, whose memory continues to give her strength along this journey. Your Portsmouth Insurance Sports Time is 7:42. Portsmouth Insurance is a TAH Benefits partner. Give Gary Duzan a call for all of your employee benefit needs. And that is a look at sports.
And thank you, Chuck. Brought to you this morning by Call Your Medical, 1661 State Route 522, where they've got occupational medicine, too, with Jamie Reynolds. And traffic, weather together on the way.
Call Your Medical in Wietersburg offers occupational medicine with nurse practitioner Jamie Reynolds. Call Your Company has closed its primary care to focus on the occupational needs of businesses in the tri-state, offering drug screens, pre-employment and DOT physicals, as well as medical surveillance, respirator fit, and audiometric testing. Whether you're an employee or an employer needing occupational medical services, go with the convenience of Call Your Medical, 1661 State Route 522, Wietersburg. Scheduling an appointment is recommended, but walk-ins are welcome. Call 740-574-8728 and be on the lookout for Call Your Home Medical coming soon.
And traffic is brought to you by the good folk at the river, Dashing Darren, Will the Thrill, and Chasing on a Grill. They're going to be there for you right on through the big weekend and the week, so stop indoors, open at 11 o'clock. And we've got to Sheer Hollow Road today, closed for about 19 days. That's going to be day and night between Pleasant Valley and Daniel Road, replacing a culvert. They are. And Henley Comstock Road closed this morning at 7. It'll be closed until 5 this afternoon. And that's between State Route 348 and Henley Deemer Road, as they are working on a boring project. I mean, it's not the fact that it's not exciting, but it's they're boring into the soil, which sounds boring to me. But if you see something we need to know about, give us a call at 354-1993. Traffic and service of your friends at the Scioto River, open 7 days a week.
Weather, a service of the Scioto County Career Technical Center, where you can begin your career as a certified pharmacy technician. Financial aid is available for those who qualify. For more information, call 740-259-5526 or visit sciotatech.org.
Your First Alert forecast from WSAZ. Mostly sunny skies, comfortable, and finally not as hot. In fact, temperatures may stay in the 70s all afternoon with a refreshing northerly breeze. A clear starlit night tonight gives the AC a break. Low temperatures in the upper 50s. Skies continue to be sunny on Tuesday, but the heat does creep back with temperatures going back to the upper 80s. I'm WSAZ News Channel 3 meteorologist Brandon Butcher on the Ohio Valley's hit music channel, Mix 99.3.
In downtown right now with sun, we've got 64 degrees as we get up and go.
Mix 99.3, Steve Hayes in the morning, the Get Up and Go Show.
And the morning show.